Good morning, and thank you for tuning in to Line 5 Show, where we are living live.
Still have your entertainment books? We will tell you who to turn it into up next.
Future public speakers may want to listen up. Details up next.
Are you a fan of dodgeball? You may want to listen up to hear about the largest dodgeball game. Details next.
It's still cold and probably not going to rain until like about Friday, which is Veterans Day. Weather up next.
Who won yesterday's football game, the Bears or the Eagles? Answer up next.
The Bears.
Oh, there's much more.
Right around the corner. Yeah, you got a piece of me, but it's just a little...
Oh my God, look, it's a homeless person.
What's wrong with you?
I just wanted some canned food.
For every can you donate, you help your home run gain spare points and also help this guy.
Yeah, that's right, dog.
And the home run winner gets a prize.
The whole enchilada, dog.
Yeah.
Oh, welcome back, and that's in the news. It's time to bring in those box tops and Campbell's labels for education. Place your box tops and labels in your homeroom envelope. These will be turned in at the end of November. The homeroom with the most box tops and labels will win a prize.
Bring your box top labels to the front office so Tesloff can cash in. The more money the school brings in through fundraisers like these, the more it can provide for technology, field trips, and parties.
If you still have any unsold entertainment books at your at home or in your locker, please return them to Ms. Lopez at room 305 by tomorrow.
If you ordered Tetzloff t-shirts or sweatshirts during registration, please see Mrs. Lopez in room 305 to pick up your order. You may pick up your order before school, during nutrition, or during lunch.
The Cerritos Optimist Club is having their annual speech Arturo contest on February 23rd and March 1st, 2012. The topic is how much autism helps me overcome obstacles. See Ms. Norietta for more information if you would like to participate. Sorry about that. Time to cross the globe and today's Around the World 7 Victoria. Good morning.
Good morning, Adam. Today's story doesn't take us far. We head over to UCI to hear about the largest dodgeball game. Imagine over 4,000 people playing a game of dodgeball. Well, this year, UCI broke the record for the largest dodgeball game with a total of 4,488 people. That's a lot. This broke their previous year's record of 1,745 people. They were hoping for 5,000, but were happy with their 4,400. Imagine over 4,000 dodgeballs flying through the air. That would be chaos. Apparently, in the end, the blue team demolished the yellow. But it didn't really matter to them because all they wanted is to beat the world record. That wraps the news around the world. Time to go back to Tetzloff with the upcoming events.
Thank you, Victoria. Looking at the Tetzloff calendar, today is the final collection date for the canned food drive. Tomorrow is Trojan Pride Day, and there is an international society meeting at lunch in room 307. Thursday is the International Society meeting at lunch. And of course, Friday is Veterans Day, so there is no school. And that wraps up the ongoing events. Time now for your Live 5 forecast.
do sign language.
So, I think you guys can hear me now. I thought I was going to have to speak sign language. And okay, this little blue part is going to... Alright, little blue part... I keep on hearing that screeching noise. You know what? Let's just go to the 5-day forecast. You guys can read. Today is going to be 67 degrees, and I love that background. I wish there were people canoeing in the background. That'd be cool. Nice. Alright, you guys can read. Alright, so on Friday it's going to be raining, and Saturday too, and Thursday and tomorrow it's going to be cloudy and 72 degrees. Let's go to Katrina with the wet pole and hope she doesn't have any mic problems.
Mrs. Pope, we have Shadi with us. Good morning, Shadi.
Good morning.
How's been your day so far?
Good.
Well, that's good. Well, now could you please read the big bubble for us?
Should Tesla students go get Veterans Day off?
Well, here's what you told us, children. Yes, because we should show respect for the people who risk their lives for us. Another guy told us no, because it takes away our time to learn. Well, we want to hear from you. Be sure to visit online lifeshow.com to vote. Send your comments to webpoll.lifeshow.com. We'll be on the air. So, Shadia, should we take Veterans Day off?
Yes.
Yeah, I kind of agree. How come we should?
I don't know. You should.
Well, thank you for coming on the show today, Shadia.
You're welcome.
Well, I'd like to give a shout-out to Max. Do you have any shout-outs?
I'd like to give a shout-out to Linda and Jenny.
Cool. Thank you. Well, now it's time to go to our Live 5 Sports Update.
Thank you, Katrina. Well, before I start, I'd like to give a shout-out to Jocelyn and David. Okay, so who won yesterday's game? The Bears did. They won 30-24 to the Eagles. And I'll be keeping you updated with other events related to sports, and there will pretty much be no more baseball games till I don't know when. Well, that's all for today's sports. Back to you, Adam.
Thank you, Bae. It's time now to test your knowledge to today's Daily 411.
What was the original name for Veterans Day? Armistice Day, Navy Day, President's Day, or War Day? Take 5.
Oh, 11.
And the answer is Armistice Day.
Anything you would like to say?
Yeah, I would like to give a shout out to Priscilla and Kyle.
I would like to give a shout out to Hannah.
And Brad.
Shout out to Brad.
He's
awesome.
Okay. Yeah. Visit our website to watch today's broadcast online at lion5show.com and follow us on Facebook, Twitter, and YouTube at lion5show.
Well, that's all our show. That's our show for today. See you back here tomorrow morning.
By the dawn's early light, what's around me we held at the twilight's last gleaming, whose broad stripes and bright stars.